Great.
So what do we have here today?
Extractions. Yes.
A bar.
A bar. Yeah, we have a telescopic bar on teeth and a secondary bar on those on this telescopic bar. And probably all of the teeth on this bar are lost.
It looks really
old.
Yeah,
it looks very bad.
No, I mean the bar is really old.
Yeah, very, very old.
And the lower teeth don't look much better.
It was made probably where the Soviet Union was still existed.
Wow, it's really broken.
This is how it looks like.
Wait, the crowns even broke down?
Yeah, the reason that they made probably this bar because in those times it was a problem to connect implants and teeth, and you couldn't do anything good when you had a couple of implants and a couple of teeth. So you can't connect in a rigid way teeth and implants. You need to do something that a little bit this, little bit that. So what they did, they made a telescopic crowns on teeth and implants, and the secondary structure on the teeth and the implants. And this is what they placed.
This is the new temporary bridge.
Yeah, this is the new temporary bridge that probably those three implants were the old implants from the old work. And if you go up, you see that in here you have some space. So you can use those implants that were on the implant part and the part of the bone that you didn't have any teeth back then and place here implants, and you'll have some kind of temporary structure on these implants and those implants. And you'll use the extra super old implants and the new ones in the same structure.
It was a screw-tend restoration?
This? No. This is removable.
A removable denture?
Yeah.
But the implants, it's a new implant that you placed?
Yeah, the implant will be a screw-tend restoration.
So this is the temporary restoration?
Exactly. Those three implants are the old ones. The two are the new ones. You can see the old implants, the new implants.
This is after the healing process?
It's before the extractions.
Before the extraction?
Yeah, because you can see the teeth. You can't make extractions and...
No, I mean here.
Yeah, you didn't had implants in this region even before, mm-hmm. So it's not a problem. For all these, for the healing process of those two implants, we placed back the old restoration.
The broken one?
The broken one, we fixed it a little bit, placed it back, and the patient went on with this restoration for another 3 months. So those two implants could also integrate. Then we extracted all the other teeth and placed the temporary bridge on those implants. Right now, what we're waiting to do is we're waiting for the gingiva and the bone to heal a little bit. To the bone regenerate, and then we'll add a couple of implants in the anterior region. When we have implants in the anterior region, it will be possible to make a good restoration, like all in six, you can call it, or seven, it will be here.
You use straight multi-units?
Yeah, in this case I used a straight multi-unit because the angulation is not that bad. The old implants were kind of parallel. The new ones, not that much, because we had some bone resorption, because this place was without teeth and without implants for a long time. So in the maxilla, the buccal part of the bone resorbed a little bit, and the angulation of the bone goes to the buccal part. So you can see the implant here is going way to the buccal side. Because it's kind of posterior implant, it's not that much of a problem. If it will be in the future, we can change the straight multi-unit to an angulated one. It won't be a problem at all. In this case, still, it's a temporary restoration. You need to wait for all the gingiva and the blood and the swelling to recover a little bit before you can continue with the restoration of this.
This is after the extraction?
Yeah, this is after the extractions. You can see that One tooth was left to support the bridge. All the other teeth were extracted and healed quite good. Right now we can remove and place back the bridge. We placed another couple of implants, and in about 3 months, we'll have the continuation of this case.
This is the place?
Yeah, this is the tooth that we left because we want to have some support in the anterior region.
And don't we want to do immediate loading?
It's always preferably to avoid immediate loading if you can. In this case, probably it is possible, but we want... It's not immediate loading, it's immediate implantation. But when you have a lot of inflammation, you want to wait a little bit for the bone to regenerate before placing more implants, because there is some kind of chance that the implants will be rejected. So we left one tooth from all the teeth, and this tooth will give us anterior support. We have 5 implants in the posterior regions. When we'll have the healing and the regeneration of the bone, we'll place another couple of implants in the anterior regions, and it will be all.
And when you will place in the future the implants in the anterior region, will you take the bridge out of the occlusion?
So let's probably first... not, because all of the support the posterior implants will take.
So you'll just tell the patient to chew on the sides more than on the front of the mouth.
Yeah, it will be probably immediate loading.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
And thank you for being with us today. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and follow to stay tuned with the latest cases. Thank you and have a great day.